Well, look who's here. It is Diane Gottsman, our etiquette expert. It's so good to see you.
Nice to see you.
This is interesting. We're talking about the pets today.
That's right.
From we got an email from a viewer.
Yes, a viewer wrote into Diane. Basically, it's a woman whose husband owns a company where he's going into a house to do repairs or this, that, or the other thing. And he's constantly having trouble with the homeowner's dogs jumping on him and invading his space. So she wanted to know if it would be okay to include on the card when they're booking their businesses, you know, some lines about pet etiquette, because apparently people don't know.
That's right. And I say absolutely, go right ahead. Mm-hmm. So a great idea would be on your little card, your little reminder card, we'll be in your neighborhood next week. When we come to the door, please contain your pet so we can concentrate on what we're doing, or we can have the conversation with you, or we can exterminate your bugs. Whatever it is, I think it's important to let them know what you expect.
Okay. I think that's great. That's like, we put our dogs way away, and it's funny because I have to shuttle them from room to room. Like, I'll put the dogs over here, you work over here, and then I take them out, you work over here, because your dogs, my dog will escape.
But you have sweet dogs. I don't think they would bother anybody. I mean, they would hurt a fly, though.
But you know
but that's
what?
Not the case all the time.
They still get in the way. Mm-hmm. Even if they don't bother you, let's say, you know, they're underfoot, and what happens if that woman or man trips? You know, there's always
liability.
Something.
Yeah, okay.
Liability.
So, number one, you say that we need to be aware of our pet's invasion of space.
But have you ever gone to someone's house and they say, oh, she must like you, look at her, and she is in your lap, she's hanging off your leg, she's doing things that, you know, you may or may not want them to do. You like pets, but you don't want them on top of you with all their fur. So our pets are closer to us than they really are the other person.
What about in the case where we have a guest over and they just aren't an animal person? They don't like dogs and they just don't do cats. Mm-hmm. They don't do Mr. Kittles very well.
Because you're a great host. You're gonna put your pets away. You're not gonna let your pets jump all over. Mm-hmm. Just because your pets live in your home, and I know people say, well, they're my babies, this is their home. Uh-huh. But as a gracious host, you make sure your guests are comfortable to be around you.
I'd agree.
Okay, this is another big issue. You walk into a house where someone owns several pets, and you have the pet smell, right?
Ooh.
I can smell it because I'm not living in it.
Yeah, that's right.
So what do?
You need to ask a trusted friend.
Okay.
Not someone that's going to say, oh, I don't smell anything, and they turn around and go, oh, you know, but I really want to know what my house smells like and be prepared for the answer.
Okay, very important. Alana, does my house smell like Mr. Kittles?
No, it doesn't. Okay. Your house smells great. Yeah, it smells like flowers. I needed to get in this air freshener that you're using.
As you mentioned, your cat litter?
It could be. Oh.
My cat litter.
Cat litter.
Great. Mr. Kittles is a good smelling cat.
You know, as we had mentioned before, Mr. Kittles, you know, is probably your baby, and they might not have any kids, as they are a guest. And that includes feeding them and nourishing them and bathing them, but it also comes to feeding them off the table. What do you think about that?
Just happened to me.
I'm guilty.
You were guilty? You fed
every
Mr.
Now
Kittles
and then.
Off the table
no,
while you were at my
Hector,
house?
Little Hector the poodle.
No. The answer is no. It happened to me last week. I was at someone's home for a nice little lunch, and she grabs a plate from her pantry to feed the dog. And I have to tell you, Alana, bad pet owner behavior.
I'm sorry. I didn't go that far. I might be you want a little
because
piece of my taco.
The plate you're eating
tortilla.
On. Old Hector over here has been licking before you. I'm just saying.
No feeding from plates.
Okay.
No.
Thank you for clearing that up.
There we go. I am constantly, like, I have this Swiffer sweeper. I'm Swiffer sweeping every day in my house because I fear that someone's going to stop by without telling me and see pet hair.
And you can see, even on a table, if there's cats that get on a table or a hardwood floor, you can see that fur, even when you're not looking.
Okay.
And when you sit down on someone's couch, you know, we're talking about pet etiquette here, so we're not just micromanaging the topic, but you sit on someone's couch and it goes, whew, with fur. So
my sister-in-law, she wears black pants and she sits on my couch. I have to come up behind her with a roller. I lint like, hold on, nobody move. Let me roll you real quick. That's badass.
Oh, right? Well, you know, I think you're fairly clean, but does it always mean if the owner is clean that our dogs are clean also?
No. Okay, here's another myth. Well, I cleaned my house so you can bring your daughter over if they're pet allergic.
Right.
It's not about being clean. It's about the dander. It's about what's on their tongue or wherever it's carried. I'm not sure what.
So even if we feel like, you know, my house is clean, but you have an allergy,
Yeah.
We got it.
And don't hide the pet and say we don't have any pets. Because
I don't have any pets. Okay, we also have to make sure that we consider our pets' welfare first. So, for example, for me, anyone's coming over to the house, I'm shoving them somewhere because I don't want them to escape. And I want them also to be good.
Yes. Okay, and that also includes talking about pets' welfare, shoving them in a purse so you can take them with you and then hiding them once you get there. I've seen that happen. Yeah. Or putting in these little outfits that they can't walk or they're too hot in. So you think about your pet.
Do you put Hector in an outfit?
What does Hector wear?
Hector's precious. He's big and fluffy and white. So I did put him in an outfit for Easter. He was my little Easter bunny.
Okay.
Yeah. So, but just besides that, that's where it stops. Yeah. Okay. We discussed this morning a dog that's very stylish. Won't go that far.
True. Yeah. And what's this about? Make sure you bring your own doggy bags and have some for your guests.
Because... No, I say you should bring your own doggy bags. Don't wait for your host.
If you've got
a pooping dog, which we all have a dog, that dog's going to poop. And no surprises. I just have to say this. You know, this was another email that we received. And, you know, they were invited over for the weekend. And guess what they brought? They brought Hector. Hector. So, it's about being a responsible pet owner.
Mm-hmm. How's Jack, your pet? It's Jack, right?
It's Charlie. Charlie!
He's so cute. I forgot his name. Now he's sad.
He's sad with his little underbite.
Oh, yeah. He's so cute. So Diane has a pet, and he's very, very cute, Charlie. He speaks English.
And cookies.
English. Charlie. Charlie Jack. He's got a new middle name.
Very good. Well, I'm glad to learn all of this about Hector. We'll be changing some things around at home.
Very good. Hector. You can check in with Diane at the Protocol School of Texas, protocolschoolofTexas.com, DianeGotsman.com. Check both websites.